student. So kind of sort of the, not philosophical, but kind of the attitude foundation that we kind of lay for the research process are kind of these three P's. And the three P's are patience, persistence, and perspective. And patience, the first P, it's important to be patient with not only like others around you, of course, but like it's important in the research process to be kind of patient with yourself. One of the hardest things when writing a research paper, like you're taking a history course and your professor says, I want you to write a history paper on the English Civil War, the War of the Roses, or something like that. You don't really know, you know, you're not taking the history class because you know everything about history. You know, generally it's a new topic to you. So there is sort of like this emotional roller coaster. That's kind of an exaggeration. But it might not be, yeah. Sometimes. But that idea that, you know, you get overwhelmed with just the topic alone and being able to, you know, just have this, you know, you get this giant 15 pages assigned, you know, it's due by the end of the term. You know, there's this sort of process where you kind of move through where you're unfamiliar with the topic. Then you learn enough about the topic where you start feeling good about the topic. And then you learn too much about the topic where you start feeling overwhelmed again. And then you kind of refine, and then you kind of feel that you know, you kind of catch your second wind and you can finish the paper. So being patient with yourself and just being aware that, like, yes, I'm kind of moving through this process. It's not going to come to get, you know, you can't just sit down and finish the paper from start to finish in, you know, a 2-hour setting or something like that. You have to be patient with yourself and know that you're going to, you know, sometimes, you know, just, you know, giving yourself that time to absorb the material and move through the process of writing a research paper will help, you know, help you feel better with yourself, but also will kind of help you come up with a better product at the end. The other thing is persistence. You know, it's easy to get discouraged. It's easy, you know, sometimes there's always one or two in class who their idea of going through the research process is sort of you pick a topic, then you research it for a bit, you find you don't like it, you pick another topic, you find you don't like it, you pick another topic. It's important to kind of stick with things. You know, we look at these research databases, and they're very powerful tools, but it does take persistence to get good at them. They're not quite, you know, they don't have the billions of dollars of ad revenue like Google does to really fine-tune these tools. So they're a little rougher around the edges. If you get more comfortable with them, you kind of can learn to use kind of the roughness of them because they do give you a lot more power. You know, like Google will pick different keywords for you and things like that, and they know that when people are searching for certain things, they know that that's not the food, it's the car or whatever. You know, like it's definitely a different kind of search, and sometimes it can get frustrating when you're like, I can't find anything on my topic. I can't, you know. So just kind of having that persistence and kind of sticking with it. With that said, it is important to keep in mind the final P, which is perspective. If you have spent an hour on your topic and you haven't found anything, you need to find another topic. Like, we're not writing research papers to change the world. I mean, maybe someday, but at this point in our careers, we're not doing the kind of research that will solve world hunger or cure cancer or anything like that. We're writing these because we want good grades. We want to maintain perspective. If this research paper is sucking up more and more of my time, that my math grades are failing, I can't even remember what my kids look like, I've lost perspective. You know, keep that in mind. Like, no, you know, and the other idea of perspective is, just because you are just tickled with your paper and tickled with your topic, if it doesn't meet the assignment criteria or what the professor is looking for, if you've lost perspective on what the assignment was and why you were writing the paper, it's not going to do you any good. Like, if it doesn't meet, you know, like nothing could be worse than sitting down and writing the most awesome 15-page paper only to find out that the professor wanted a 5-minute presentation, you know, or something like that. You know, being able to sit down and, you know, go line by line through the syllabus or through the assignment, make sure that you understand what that you have proper perspective when you're putting together this assignment or paper. So those are the three P's.